shift gears over to the women's side with women's basketball coach Kendra Fauston, a veteran of the show. You've been here many times. Good to have you back.
Sure. Thanks for having me.
I think we should start with the big news, the addition to the Niagara family. You have a new baby.
Yeah, that's my favorite news.
That's your favorite thing to talk about
now. It's great.
Well, I actually want to ask you how that fits in with the team, because what's it like to balance that responsibility with being the head coach of a basketball team?
Well, it's certainly an adjustment. You know, my son Cal travels with us. My husband travels with us a little bit. My mother travels with us a little bit. Logistically, it's a nightmare, but it's certainly worth working out. It's the biggest challenge and the best thing I've ever done. Cal travels with us, and our team is great with him. And you know, they'll take him for a little bit. We'll be, you know, on the bus or whatnot, and so they help out as well. Actually,
it almost sounds like the plot for like a sitcom, you know, like baby on a basketball team. But it's not a surprise to me to hear that the team would take to it, because a lot of times sports teams, you'll talk about, you're like a family. And when you bring in a new addition, it's not a surprise to hear that everyone just kind of takes to it.
Well, and, you know, and I've said this on newer occasions. I'm lucky enough where both of my families get to be intertwined. And I'm lucky enough that I work at a place like Niagara where, you know, we can make that happen. And you know, being a basketball coach has certain demands that aren't always conducive to having a family or certainly having children. And this way, you know, we can work both out.
So how is preparation different on a weekly basis with this added in for you?
Well, you know, I'm not probably in the office as much other than working. I come to the office. I try to get as much accomplished as I can. And in the time that I'm there, you know, I'll work for at home at different times at night. I watch film, you know, after my son goes to bed. So from about 8 till probably 11 or 12, you know, that's my time to watch film when he's in bed, and, you know, it's quiet. And, you know, during the day, I can get business done in the office, and be home with him every night.
And did you miss a few games?
I missed 5 games at the beginning of the season.
Obviously, you're out with a good reason, but did you find yourself really missing it and really feeling the need to get back as soon as possible?
Yeah, it was really hard to be away from our group. You know, it was a great reason, but I really missed being around our team and my other family. You know, Corinne Jones did a great job as an interim head coach, and so I felt comfortable that way. So it wasn't a rush in that sense to get back. But just missing being around it. It's a huge part of who I am in my life.
Well, let's talk about the team this season. 5 wins, an improvement over last year. Mm-hmm. What have you seen this year? I know last year you were ravaged by injuries. You had a number of issues in that respect, and even when we're down to 4 players in a game last year. So that hasn't happened this year. You've been able to stay healthy for the most part and have a better season?
Yeah, absolutely. We're staying healthy. We're still young. You know, we play 2 seniors, and then the rest are freshmen and sophomores. So we're still young, and we're still learning, but I think, you know, we're taking steps forward, which is really good for us.
An upcoming game is coming against Fairfield and, of course, Canisius, the one that everyone kind of points to, no matter what the program we're talking about, Canisius and the rivalry. So does it feel any different to you to be preparing for Canisius when that time of year comes around?
No, it's the same. I mean, it's a rivalry game, so it feels different in that way. You know, but we don't do anything differently. So we prepare the same way. But yes, it does feel a little bit different.
So preparation the same, execution maybe a little bit different. Like once you get out there and it's that
time. Yeah, I think there's a little extra edge that our players bring to that game. You know, a little bit more intensity. It's always a little more physical than any game that both teams have played all year.
And you've got a Kids Day coming up against Ryder January 27th. Tell us about Kids Day and what that is.
Well, it's mayhem. It's great. It's great to have all those kids in the building and be able to see our players who, again, I'm biased, but I think that our players are great role models, to see them on and off the court. It's loud. It's fun. It's an atmosphere that college basketball is about, and it's so much fun to play in and coach in.
2,000 kids from Niagara Falls schools and Niagara Wheatfield schools.
Yeah.
So.
Bring your earplugs.
Very cool. And bring your son for that one, right?
Yes. He's going to have his earplugs.
Big cheerleader?
Yeah, he's been in a lot of gyms, and he can handle the buzzer, but that many kids will test him a little bit.
We've got Allie Morris coming up next. Very quickly, a thought on the type of player she is. What do I need to ask her?
Oh, she's the most competitive player I've ever coached.
I heard something very similar. I heard she's like a stone face and fearless.
Fearless. That's a great word.
We'll find out next. Thanks very much. Good to see you. Congratulations.